early.
Oh. My dog's doing a poo. Morning, Lucy. I'm sorry about Asha, she's doing a poo. Just turn this on. I was going, welcome, I'm a bit early, and suddenly see. It's all very zen. So I'm in my garden, guys. Hopefully you've got a mat or a towel, some water, maybe a cushion, if those of you that aren't used to practicing yoga, have something like a big cushion or two cushions just for support. And I just want you to, for those of you who don't know, that's my dog Asha. So settle down, settle into your place. So come into a seated position. We're going to be focusing on grounding through the root chakra. The root chakra is kind of here at the base of your spine, and it represents balance, grounding. So I know that a lot of people are feeling potentially ungrounded. Some people, maybe not all people, but ungrounded, maybe a bit unbalanced, maybe a bit stressed, maybe a bit worried. This is just going to be a very gentle practice, open to everybody this morning. So settling down in that position, I want you to really find kind of a connection to this part of you here, like the pelvic floor. Just try and find a connection. Close down the eyes. See if you can find a connect point. Doesn't have to be strong. I just want you to feel a sense of this lower part of your spine, the connection to the ground or your mat or your towel, whatever it is you're sitting on. If you've got your eyes closed, keep them closed. But if you don't want to have your eyes closed, just take your eyes gently and look towards a point on the floor. So I want you to try and focus on coming inwards, going inwards, just giving yourself this space for the next 20, 25 minutes or so. Feeling grateful that you came to give yourself this space and time. And if there's anyone in particular that you feel grateful for, just focus your attention on them, just for a breath or two. Focusing on the breath, inhale through the nose, exhale through the mouth. Start to inhale and exhale with a big out breath, let it all go. I want you to just, as you're doing that, lift the chest, roll the shoulders back, bring your hands into prayer, or you can bring your hands here into a mudra, feeling the connection with your root chakra. Deep breath in. Big breath out, lifting your heart, lifting your chest. Seeing if you can kind of pull from the top of your head up. Feel the connection all the way down to the ground. Now feel free to open your eyes if you want to and unpray your hands. And then what we're going to do is just bring them together, create some energy. So bring those hands together, big rub. And just really, really, really feel that energy you're creating with your hands. And take that your pelvic floor area, feel the energy there, keep the heart open, and just gradually take the hands from the root up your spine, up the front body, all the way around. You're just just giving energy to yourself and any areas that you feel particularly need them. We're going to do that again one more time. Big rub of the hands, create the energy, feel that energy as you separate the hands. Take it to the root chakra here. Shoulders back, heart open, lift the hands. This time we're going to lift the hands all the way up. Prayer at the top. Deep inhale. Exhale. We're going to take one hand down here and just stretch open. I'm going to sit a little bit further back so you can see me. We're just coming up and over. Inhale, we're going to do the same thing on the other side. Press down, lift up, and over. Just be gentle with yourself. If this is enough here, great. If you can lean right over, great. Just find what feels good for your own body. And honor, completely honor always where your body is and where you are at. We're going to do one more each side. Hand down, lift up, and over. Other side, inhale, exhale, over. I'm just going to do that a little bit quicker now, one side. We're going to do that twice, both sides, a little bit quicker. Oh, little Esha. Good, come to the center. Hands to prayer, hands to heart, hands to your third eye. Now I'm going to show you from the side, we're just going to do a seated cat-cow. So again, keep your focus in on this kind of pelvic floor area, rooting down. We're going to round off this back here, and then we're going to lift and come forwards. So it's a seated cat-cow position, really open the heart, keep grounded through the hips. We're going to do some hip opening work shortly. So just do this in your own time. Open, lift the heart, round off on the exhale. Inhale, lift, open. Exhale. Guys, what we're going to do here is just come forwards very gently. So I'm just going to press forwards onto my knees. And take the knees wide and sit back and come into an extended child's pose here. So my arms are forwards. I'm going to press this bit down, press my hips down. I just rest my forehead gently on the mat. Now you can wiggle about here if you want to, but I just want you to keep feeling this connection between this base, root chakra and the ground and your breath and your being. But just move intuitively for you. So I feel like I want to take my hands over to the right and then the other side. But you stay still if you feel that's perfect for you. Trust your body, always trust yourself. I think women find it extraordinarily hard to trust their intuition. They're not used to listening. So you just find what feels good for you. There is no rush. Now from there, guys, so we should be in this extended child's pose, or you may have kind of wiggled around a bit, and that's fine. Focusing your attention down onto that root chakra. Show you from the front. What I want you to very gently do is walk the hands back as we're going to come into this kind of hip opening. Now, some of you might just find that you're here with your heels up and you might need to come down, and that's fine. So what I'm looking for is this kind of movement here. So very gently, foot down. Now my other heel is lifted. And I'm just position that you find comfortable here. So we're still opening up through the hips. But if you're with me, and it doesn't matter where you are, as long as you, again, trust yourself, trust your body, and just play around with this a bit. If you want to just lift your hips, feel the stretch down the back of your legs, do that. Come down. You just play. Focusing here, grounding down through this root chakra. Balance, stability. Often if the root chakra's out of balance, we feel scared. We feel insecure. Now guys, wherever you are, if you're staying seated, stay down. I'm looking for this kind of froggy position. Now my dog's eating my laptop. Just breathe. Now I don't care if you're here, I don't care if you're seated. I just care that you are here on this mat, that you're giving yourself some time. Again, you can play here if you want to. Keep that chest lifted even if you're seated. Really gentle breathing. Big deep inhale. Big release with that breath. Take the hands forward. Lift the hips. So I'll just show you from the side. So if you're staying seated, please stay seated. But I'm down. Now I'm going to take the hands forward and lift. I'm just going to wiggle about a bit here, feel the stretch down the back of the legs, sit back down, rooted down, one more like that and then we're going to go into our first down dog. So again, you can play with that here. Downward dog. So if you're in your seated pose here, just bring the hands forwards, tap the toes, lift up. Now I want you to take and spread the hands and externally rotate the shoulders and then just play here. Most of you shouldn't be able to get the heels down, which means you bend through this leg, press those hips up. And then just gently walk your heels down, alternating. Come down onto the floor, untuck the toes, extended child's pose, feel the root, ground back down, connect back that root chakra. Big deep breaths, breathing in, let it go with that breath. Okay, we're coming back to down dog, so hands just wider than shoulders at this point, tuck the toes and lift the hips. Get comfortable in this position first. Now at any point, guys, you can come down to a child's pose. Now what we're going to do very gently is take this left leg off, step it forwards, okay? Now when you've got it stepped forwards, I want you to focus on that back foot, but being on a train track, not a tightrope, as you come up. Going into warrior one. Lift you up a bit. not twisted, so I'm still facing front. I'm going to take my arms up. So this is our warrior one. Just a little practice here. Bring yourself down. Take your hands to frame that left foot. Step it back into your downward facing dog. Now focus here again on this grounding piece. Focus your attention, your breath. We're going to take the right leg up. We're going to do the same on the other side. So that's step forwards. Both feet plant down. You're facing to the front. Arms come up. Just rest here. So that back foot, the heel is down. Front foot. And get your weight in the outside of that foot. Lift up. And then release down. Very gently, hands frame that right foot, step it back into your downward facing dog. Okay, guys, left foot comes off. Step that foot forwards. Again, gently bring yourself up, take the hands all the way up. Now, what I'm looking for here, if you feel strong in this position and you want to stay here, great. Stay here, hands can be at prayer or they can be up. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take my hands behind me, roll the shoulders back, and I'm going to gently bring myself forwards. Now you just come wherever you want to. It's called the humble warrior. Grounding down through your feet, very gently. Gentle with yourself, guys. Release the hands. Frame that left foot. I want you to step up here. Forward fold. Forward fold. Now gently, gently, gently. You might need to bend through these front legs. Bend the knees. Relax the head. Just sway if you want to. Relax the shoulders. Well, you don't have to sway at all. If you feel unbalanced, ungrounded, just stay strong in your feet. Coming up very gently, just uncurl, uncurl, uncurl. Big lift up. Grounding through the feet. Hands to prayer. We're going to do the same thing on the other side. Inhale. Hands to prayer. Just very gently coming down into forward fold. Then we take the hands forwards, feet back into downward facing dog. The hands on the fingers, weight in the outside on that little finger. Lift the hips, feel the stretch in the back of the leg. Right leg comes up. You want to step that right leg forwards. Warrior one, so both feet are planted on a train track. You're facing the front. And you very gently bring the hands up. Now stay here if this is okay for you. Focus on squaring the hips, grounding again here. Focus and connect into this point. I'm going to take my hands behind me, roll the shoulders. Just gently drop forwards. Just come where you feel safe. You feel stable. You feel balanced. So the feet meet. Come into your forward fold. Now what I'm going to down. And we're going to take the feet in front. See if you can flex the feet. And just see how far forward you can reach. So if both of your hands are either side, just if you can come here, great, just stay here. But if you can walk those fingers forwards, walk them forwards. If you can touch your toes, touch your toes. The grounding comes from here. Focus and connect. Here, grounding. Feel the strength in those legs. Feel the balance within you. Very gentle with yourself here. Again, move intuitively. If you feel like you want to kind of just take one shoulder down and the other one, feel the stretch in the back of the legs. You don't have to be rigid. You can move however you want to. If you want to just bring your arms up and round, staying grounded in your sit bones. Grounded through your sit bones on your mat or your towel. You're going to take your foot into your arm. And I'm just going to make a little cradle in the crease of my elbow. Kind of just gently cradle this leg. Now staying with the grounding here through the pelvic floor. See if you can lift up the pelvic floor. Gently cradle this leg. Show your legs some love. Now you might feel that, you might not be able to have it as high as me, but you might feel that in this area here. So this side thigh. Just cradle it gently, feel that stretch. If you want to come forwards, do that. Listen to your body. Where does it feel nice? Where can you feel that stretch? The grounding piece, what's it saying to you? When that grounding piece is, when that root chakra is strong, we feel safe, we feel balanced, we feel secure. So say to yourself, I am safe. Release that leg. Shake it off. Come forwards again. Just come wherever you can, so it's fine if it's here, I don't care. You focus on you, being gentle with you. Take that other leg now, into the crease of the elbow. Gently cradle it. Rock it backwards and forwards. Repeat the mantra. I am safe. I am loved. If you want to come forwards, please do that. If you don't, just stay where you are. Intuitively. And even if you've just sat with me, just sat and watched me do this practice, that's wonderful that you've given yourself just even that space and time to do that. So releasing the leg. What I want you to do now is just gently, gently, gently come back down. Really gently. All the way to the floor. Just super slow. Again, focusing and connecting with this grounding here. And you're lay. Just lay. Close your eyes down. This is your time to breathe. Lay. Close your eyes. Have some space. And sense that deep space within. The deep space within you that's always there. It's always got your back. That's underneath the noise. That well of being. You are that grounding. Start to bring your awareness back to your breath. Breathing gently in, breathing very gently out. Focus your awareness in your heart and then all the way down into your tummy and then to the base. The root chakra, that strong, grounded part of you that is your place of balance, that is your place of rest. And as you go through the day, if you find your mind wandering off, please just bring your center and your attention back to that grounding piece. Walk on the earth if you need to. Sit down with your sit bones on the ground. Bring yourself back, because it's always there.